We have with us this morning former Comelec Commissioner Louie Guia. First thoughts on how this will affect preparations for the elections. Commissioner Guia, thanks for joining us this morning. Good to have you.
I'm glad to be here. Thank you for the opportunity.
Right, Commissioner Guia, what do you think is the immediate effect of the extension of the voter registration? I mean, Comelec has said it will affect internal operations, but we have yet to hear details about which operations exactly will be affected by the voter registration. From your experience, what are the immediate effects?
No, this is it. I mean, Comelec from the get-go is planned the election in such a way that the registration would end in September 30 and all the subsequent activities relating to the preparation for the election will depend on a September 30 deadline, meaning the voters list will be finalized by September 30 and the number of voters will be finalized by September 30. Not really September 30 because September 30 is just the deadline of the filing for applications for registration. The Election Registration Board would have to meet the third Monday of October. So now you advance that. You delay that a bit for a month. So instead of the Election Registration Board, which approves application for registration, meeting on the third Monday of October, they would have to meet third Monday of November, probably. Mm-hmm. Okay. And what does that mean? The number of voters per precinct will determine how many ballots you would have to allocate per precinct. Remember, the system chosen by Comelec necessitates that there should be only the right number of ballots that would have to be allocated per precinct. And you have to customize. You have to customize the ballot depending on the candidate in each constituency. The way things are in our election, there are about 1,700 constituencies or different ballot phases. So dapat, you know, naka-customize or naka-configure in that way, no? And the ballot printing would have to start by February, which means therefore that all the configurations, you know, the ballot printing should match the way the machine would be configured to read the marks on the ballot. In other words, there are a lot of dependencies from the point where the number of voters would be determined, number of voters per precinct. So ang daming pwedeng mangyari. Now, I know that in the previous elections, no, as presidential elections, 2016 and 2013, the deadline for registration was October 30. So probably Comelec may still be able to do it, but it's going to be very, very tight for Comelec.
Mm-hmm. So there are certain operations. What about the system on the biometrics involved in the registration process? Will that also be affected?
Well, no, biometrics actually is independent from the voting process. So it only pertains to the registration. So it would not, but as you know, I mean, it's also, you know, you have machines there which have been, you know, used for quite some time. The registration did not start in September. The registration started in August 2019. And it is only in September 2021 that, you know, you see crowding. So siguro strained yung mga makina. So I am not sure if that would be a problem though, but I think hindi naman.
Mm-hmm. No, but those who are pushing for the extension of the voter registration period are saying that in the past, they have been extended up to October the year prior to the election year. And in fact, the law says it should be 120 days continuing registration should continue 120 days before the election day itself. But what's the problem with this law? This is a 1996 law, and you have subsequent laws mandating automated election. What seems to be the problem with that law, Commissioner Guia?
Well, first and foremost, Comelec has chosen a system which will require early preparations. No, you cannot start preparation under the kind of system chosen by COMELEC in January. Mm-hmm. In other words, you cannot finalize the list of voters by January. You have to do it earlier because you have to have a lot of preparations. You want the number of, for instance, as I've been saying earlier, you want the number of precincts or the number of voters per precincts to be precise, to match. No, hindi yung, it's not just a counting machine where, you know, you any ballot that you feed into it will be counted. No, you customize each of the 100,000 vote counting machine would have to be customized to what is appropriate in the precinct, you know. So ganun yung pinili eh. And that's why you have to have an earlier preparation, a longer preparation for it. So hindi naman siya manual eh, na madali lang gawin.
But was this situation, Commissioner Gia, was this missed by the lawmakers when they actually filed the subsequent laws mandating the automated election? Because obviously the 120-day period before the elections is not enough if you're going to follow all the preparations needed for an automated election. So is there a lack of foresight here on the part of Congress in not anticipating this problem?
So there's a provision in the automation law that allows COMELEC to adjust the deadlines in to fit the system that it has chosen to implement. So that's just the reason why, you know. But of course, I can understand that, you know, you would want to have more voters in the list because that will make the elections more participatory and therefore more meaningful. But what has been chosen is a system that requires longer preparation. So I think the decision to advance the deadlines has to do with the kind of vote counting tabulation system that was chosen.
Mm-hmm. And so given the extension for a month, of course, COMELEC has decided to extend it by a month, are you anticipating any concerns that might take place because of this extension of voter registration?
I don't like to anticipate any concern, but what will happen is that, you know, you reduce the room for error, you reduce the buffer, comfort buffer of COMELEC in addressing what might be unforeseen. And that is the reason why they set it in the first place, way back in 2019, that the registration end on September 30. Nakaplano na yun na September 30. Now, of course, you know, it's also justified that we did not anticipate COVID. Yes. But that is also one consideration why COMELEC need more lead time. Mm-hmm. It's the COVID pandemic. You know, registration happens on the ground. You have, you know, you have 1,600 municipalities managing the registrations in the field. And it's not just, you know, receiving registration. They have to do a lot of post-registration reporting, and they have to submit all these lists in an accurate list in the central office for the central office to finalize it, because decisions are made in the central office as to how many precincts are going to be constituted, and all the procurement and all the procurement necessities that would depend on the number of ballots. Mm-hmm. And the number of voters that would have to be so there should be lesser delays in delivery. There should be lesser mistakes in the operations. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And then dapat hindi nagkakamali ang COMELEC because of the extension.
Mm-hmm. And of course, this is the first time that we're seeing or holding an elections under the pandemic, and so we're seeing changes.
That is where COMELEC is coming from. And that's why they were initially hesitant to grant the extension. That's why we have to thank them. And we have to honor that decision, because it's not an easy decision for COMELEC by, you know, just registering, make use of the extension, make elections more meaningful because of that. But what we do not realize, you know, what prompted the decision to extend probably are the visuals where you see voters lining up early in the morning and having to vote only 8 hours after. But what you don't realize is that you have same COMELEC people there 7 days a week, almost 10 hours every day, pare-parehong tao yon. Aren't they, you know, sacrificing their health?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And of course, you've had changes in terms of filing of the COCs. They're now holding it in a tent, in an open tent in Sofitel instead of the COMELEC headquarters in Intramuros. These changes, how do you think this will impact the flow or, in fact, the operations of COMELEC?
It adds more difficulty, so to speak, because it's not as easy as before. But filing certificate of candidacy should be as simple as, you know, candidates just going to COMELEC, submitting their certificates of candidacy. It could not be more than that, you know, except that some candidates would want to have some, you know, media mileage in doing so. Mm-hmm. But it's not just in PICC, because COMELEC, because filing of certificate of candidacy also happens in all COMELEC offices, all 1,600 plus municipalities. We're talking about the national election, and you know, we fancy looking at those filing their certificate of candidacy for president, vice president, but there are also elections for governors, congressmen, and you know, mayors, and this will happen all over the country, and these are all managed by your local COMELEC.
Mm-hmm. And this cannot be done online, or at least by an alternative mode, without requiring the presence of the candidates themselves in COMELEC offices?
There is your legal framework. Our law requires personal filing. And probably you can have a representative, but it's still personal filing.
Mm-hmm. All
so
right.
We have rigid sets of election laws, and that is the reason why it's not easy for COMELEC to adjust to what might be necessary under a pandemic, no? So we haven't seen this. There has been a lot of proposal to modernize our election laws, but you know, maybe it's not a priority to the decision makers.
Mm-hmm. All right, thank you so much for your thoughts this morning, former COMELEC Commissioner Louis Guia.
My pleasure, thank you.